हेलो फ्रेंड्स, लेट अस नाउ लर्न अबाउट द टेम्परेचर ऑफ स्पर्मेटोजेनेसिस। स्पर्मेटोजेनेसिस अकर्स एट ए लोअर दैन कोर टेम्परेचर। ओके, द टेस्टिस इज प्रेजेंट इन द स्क्रोटम। सो दिस स्क्रोटम इज आउटसाइड द बॉडी कैविटी एंड हियर द टेम्परेचर इज 35 to 36 डिग्रीज और 1 to 2 डिग्री सेल्सियस less than body temperature. Why is this temperature less? This is because of the counter current arrangement. This is because of counter current arrangement of arteries and veins in the scrotum. There is counter current arrangement of testicular arteries and veins. So this will help in heat exchange and thus it decreases the temperature. Okay, so if this is the testis, you will see the arrangement of veins and arteries something like this, like counter current arrangement, that is together. So as a result, exchange of this occurs very easily. Heat exchange occurs very easily, so temperature decreases. Right? Now, sperms, once the sperms are produced, the sperms are stored in, where does this, they are stored? The sperms are stored, where are the sperms stored? Sperms are stored in epididymis. And what happens in the epididymis is the question now. So in the epididymis, what are the changes that occur during sperm maturation in epididymis? The changes that occur in sperm maturation in epididymis is, first there will be progressive increase in forward motility of the sperms and there will be increase in ability to fertilize and there will be maturation of acrosome of sperm occurs and there is molecular reorganization and there is molecular reorganization of plasma membrane. There will be molecular reorganization of plasma membrane, that is there will be lipids cause stabilization of plasma membrane, whereas proteins will help in shedding. There will be, according to proteins, there will be shedding and acquisition of new proteins will occur. Right? Then there will be also acquisition of receptors for proteins of zona pellucida. Even for the proteins of zona pellucida, they will generate the receptors. Okay, there is increased disulfide bond present between the cysteine residues in sperm nucleoproteins. There is development of double bonds. Okay, then there is topographical regionalization of glycosidic residues. There is topographical regionalization of glycosidic residues occur. And there is also accumulation of mannosylated residues. If there is accumulation of mannosylated residues on the periacrosomal membranes, this is also seen in maturation of the sperm, and also you will see presence of decreased cytoplasm and cell volume. So these are the changes which occur in the epididymis. Okay, then once the sperms reach female genital tract, once the sperm reach female genital tract, now the sperms move up the uterus to isthmus of uterine tube. Once they move to the isthmus of uterine tube, here they slow down, and here they undergo a process called as capacitation. So this capacitation occurs in the uterus. In capacitation, there occurs increased motility of spermatozoa occurs, and they also facilitate their preparation for acrosomal reaction. They will start preparing for acrosomal reaction. These occurs in the female genital tract. Whereas all these changes which I have said, all these changes, okay, will occur in the epididymis. Okay. Now, so what are actual changes which occur in the capacitation? I have said you these two will occur. So how does these occur? What are the microscopically what happens? Okay, so in the capacitation, the actual changes are, this capacitation actually requires 1 to 10 hours, and in the capacitation you see the following changes to occur. So there will be the uterine and fallopian tube fluids wash away. The uterine and fallopian tube fluids which are there, they will wash away the inhibitory factors in the sperm. The inhibitory factors which are present on the sperm, they are washed away by the uterine and fallopian fluids. Okay, why should these inhibitory factors be released? That is because when the sperm is in male genital tract, then this sperm is exposed to the floating vesicles in the seminal tubules. There are some floating vesicles in the seminal tubules. Okay, the sperm is attached to these floating vesicles. These floating vesicles contain lots of cholesterol. Okay, this cholesterol is slowly added to the cell membrane of the sperm. It is added to the cell membrane of the sperm. So slowly, when it is added to the cell membrane of the sperm, the cell membrane will become tougher. Cell membrane toughening occurs, and this will prevent enzyme release. To prevent that, here this will prevent enzyme release. Okay, so the enzymes which are present in the sperms are not released because of this cholesterol. Okay, after ejaculation, in the vagina, the sperm will swim up into the uterus and lose the cholesterol. The cholesterol membrane which is present, that is lost in next few hours. In next few hours, it loses this cholesterol. And now, because it has lost the cholesterol, the membrane becomes weaker. Because now the membrane is weaker, now what happens? This membrane becomes more permeable to calcium. And it is weaker, so it is permeable to calcium. So calcium enters the sperm. So calcium, obviously calcium causes action potential. It will give the sperm a powerful whiplash movement. So it starts to flow faster, go faster. Okay, like it helps it to run. Okay, now these calcium channels, these calcium which enter the sperm, these calcium ions also causes changes in edge of the sperm, edge of the acrosome. It also causes change in the edge of the acrosome, and as a result there is release of enzymes occurs rapidly and easily, and thus the sperm, with the help of these enzymes, and this will penetrate the zona pellucida easily. Well, penetrate the granulosa cell mass. And also it penetrates the zona pellucida of ovum. Okay, so these are the different changes that occur in the spermatogenesis. Right. Thank you for watching.